We'll be talking about a transformation of function. So transformation of functions. So we will start by saying that y equals f at x. So that means y is the function of f at x. And the following transformation can apply to the function f at x. So we will write this as y equals, I'm going to use a different color to write this transformation. That this is a times f at k times x plus d plus c. So let me fix this d properly. So you can actually apply this four transformation factor to a function. So let's talk about what each of this does. Well, first of all, we have to say that, okay, a, k, d, and c, they are all greater than 1. So what does it mean by y equals a times f at x? That means you stretch the graph by a factor a vertically. So what if it's y equals f at x divided by a? That's the same as 1 over a times f at x. So what do you do here? You compress. Well, I'll write this better. Compress the graph by a factor a vertically. So how about y equals to f at k at x? So we're doing this one here now, f at k at x. So now that means you compress the graph by a factor of k horizontally. How about y equals to f at x over k? That's the same as saying that f at 1 over k times x. In this case, you stretch the graph by a factor k horizontally. Let's look at the D. That's the same as saying y equals to f at x plus d. What's that implying? This shift the graph to the left by d units. How about f at x minus d? What's that equal to? What does that imply? Well, let's shift. This one will be shifting the graph to the right by d units. So now we are going to look at this one next. C. What does it mean by transforming the graph f at x plus c? This means shifting the graph upward by c units. The next, how about this? F at x minus c. This means shifting the graph downward by c units. Now we have talked about all possible transformation here. Times a divided by a times k divided by k plus d minus d plus c minus c. So let's look at all of them in a graph. So the best thing to represent is, let's use the function f at x equals to x squared. Because if I use the linear function, it's hard to see because it's just a straight line. I don't know how you can see, like, oh, is this being compressed? Is it being shifted? Oh, you can see if it's being shifted, but it's hard to see if it's compressed or stretched. So let's plot this one in the graph first. So let's have a look at this one here. So I have some x variable and f at x variable here. So let's start from 0. Then to the left of 0, negative 1, negative 2. And then to the left of 0, to the right of 0 is 1 and 2. When you plug 0 in here, f at x is 0. When you plug negative 1 here, f at x is 1. When you plug negative 2 here, f at x is 4. Same here, if you plug 1 here into x, f at x is 1. You plug 2 into x, f at x is 4. So with this, I can sketch the graph. So let me try this. There's a graph, a Cartesian plane. I'm going to label this. Let's say this is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So maybe this 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Over here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm going to call this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. Now, what is 0 is 0, so we have, so let me use a different color. When it's 0, the dot is here. Well, when it's negative 1, it's 1. So if negative 1, 1. There's one dot here. When it's 1, when x is 1, y is 1. So f at x is 1. And over here, when x is negative 2, f at x is 4. When x is 2, and that x is 4 as well. So now you can actually scratch this graph by connecting this point here. That doesn't look too good here. Let's draw here again. It's just a rough sketch. It might not look perfect here. So that's a parabola of y equals x squared. Now, let's apply the transformation of f at x plus c and minus c first. So, what I'm going to do is, let me go to the left side here. I would actually do f at x equals x squared plus 3. Let's say that. So f at x. Okay, so this means that it's going to shift the graph upward by 3 units. So let's talk about this coordinates, right? I'm going to use, let's say, negative 3 this time. So this one will be negative 4, negative 5. I want to get the points in vicinity. What will you plug negative 3 here? Actually, no. In this case, I'm going to use the zero point. So zero here, negative one, negative two, one and two. I can use the same x coordinate because that's the way I can demonstrate this effect. So zero, when I plug zero here, zero plus three is three. If I put in negative one, well, that's one, then plus three is four. I put in negative 2, negative 2 squared is 4, 4 plus 3 is 7. Same here, 1 squared is 1, plus 3 is 4. 2 squared 4 plus 3 is 7. Now, I can draw a graph here. I will label this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's, this side doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1. Wow. Try to make it proportionate. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now, when it's 0, it's 3. Y is 3. So when x is 0, y is 3. So I'm going to use a different color. Basically, will be here. When x is negative 1, y is 4. So this is negative 1. Y is 4. When x is negative 2, basically this is negative 2. Y is 7. So when x is 1, y is 4. When x is 2, y is 7. So good, now I have enough points. I can connect this graph together. I'm gonna try to do a rough sketch here. So here, the curve would still be the same shape, except the only thing is this was shifted upward by 3 units. So the same curve shifted upward by 3 units as demonstrated here. as demonstrated here. Okay. So now, let's do one for x equals to, well, f at x equals to minus 3 here. So we will do this. Minus 3. Minus 3. So, what would these points be here? Well, I can still use this 0, negative 1, negative 2, 1 and 2. When you plug 0 here, it's 0 squared 0. So minus 3 is negative 3. 1, negative 1 square is 1, minus 3 is negative 2. Negative 2 square minus 3 is 1. Basically, negative 2 square is 4. Now, 1. 1 square minus 3 is negative 2. 2 square is 4 minus 3 is 1. So, now I have enough information that I can sketch a graph again. Here. Same thing here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I will label this. Label this here, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is negative 1. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. Okay, so we can plot the points. I'm going to use the different color. 0 and x is 0, y is negative 3. So this one is here. When x is negative 1, y is negative 2. X is negative 1, y is negative 2, so we'll be here. When x is negative 2, y is 1, so it's here. Same thing on this side, when x is 1, y is negative 2. Same thing here, when x is 2, y is 1. So we have enough points, we can actually draw this. It's connecting this dot, going here, connecting to this dot, and go up here. Well, it's a rough sketch, but let me still draw it better, try it. So here's the parabola. So compared to the original function here, it's just the same shape but just shift down 3 units. So we have just demonstrated this property here. So let's try to demonstrate this one here, f at x plus d and fx minus d. So I'm going to erase everything here. So in this case, I will do f at x, or y equals f at x. So x minus 3 square. Well, no. I don't have f here. So basically this is this. I was write this one here. F at x equals to this. So this is supposed to show you that in shifting 3 units to the right. So let me get some points here. Coordinate. So we can plot the graph. Well, in this case, I will use 3, then 2 and 1, 4 and 5. What happens when you plug 3 into x here? 0, 0 squared is 0. You plug 2 here is negative 1 times square is 1. You put 1 here, 1 minus 3 is negative 2, negative 2 squared is 4. Same here, plus 4 here is 1, 1 squared is 1. 5 minus 3 here, 2, 2 squared is 4. Now, I have enough point to plug the graph, to draw the graph. So I will write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now let's plug the point. When it's 3, x is 3, y is 0. So basically here. When x is 2, y is 1. So here. When x is 1, y is 4. So here. When x is 4, y is 1. So here. When x is 5, y is 4. So now I have enough point to connect the graph. So let me sketch this. Now this side too. So that's the rough sketch of this parabola, but it apparently is the same shape but shifted 3 units to the right. So now next one. Now this time I will do x plus 3 squared. So according to this, it is supposed to shift the graph to the left by d unit. So let's look at this. Extend this. So this time I will use negative 3. Negative 4, negative 5 to the left of the graph, now to the right of the graph, negative 2, negative 1. So when you plug in negative 3 into x, right, plus 3 is 0, 0 squared is 0. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1 squared is 1. Negative 5 plus 3, negative 2 squared is 4. Negative 2 plus 3, 1, 1 squared is 1. Negative 1 minus 3, so negative 1 plus 3, so 2 squared is 4. Now I can actually draw a graph again. Label this that will be too far, so label this here. So this one here, actually I will not need to label the bottom, so because the graph will be on this side. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I'm going to use a different color. When x is negative 3, y is 0. Actually here. When x is negative 4, y is 1. Here. When x is negative 5, y is 4. Will be here. When x is negative 2, y is 1. Here. When x is negative 1, y is 4. Here. Oh. Can draw this better here. Say, need to be a little bit more proportionate. So here, so I can rewrite this negative 5 just show that it's more proportional of the graph, right? Because the distance. Now, I can connect these dots though to a parabola. It's just a rough sketch. It doesn't look perfect, but the shape has not changed. All it did is just shift the graph to the left by 3 units. Okay. Let's talk about this one here. Stretching the graph horizontally by a factor A vertically. I will erase all this. So I would say f at x equals to, let's say 5x squared. So 5 is the a. So let's get the coordinate here and see how this looks like. So we'll use 0, negative 1, negative 2. This one, 1 and 2. You plug 0 here. 0 times 5 is 0. Negative 1 square 1 times 5 is 5. Negative 2 square 4. 4 times 5 is 20. 1 square, this one is 5. You plug in 2 here. 2 square 4. 4 times 5 is 20. I have enough points to draw this graph. If I can draw this, extend this, okay. No. Let me extend this. Okay. So I will label this. Label this. Well, I just label the top here because the graph will be in the first quadrant anyway, the one I will try to demonstrate. So let me try to do an increment of 5 in this axis here. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. This one I would say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. Okay. Let me use a different color to plot this. So when x is 0, y is 0 here. When x is negative 1, y is 5, so it will be here. X is negative 2, y is 20, so here. When x is 1, y is 5. When x is 2, y is 20. Now, I have enough dots, let's connect the graph to draw to do a rough sketch of the parabola. So here, here. So what's this shape here? So let's use the dot, the points here. We use and compare with the y value of the corresponding x value here. Now we did say that before when f and x, oh, gonna use a different color here. Let me use green. F and x equals to x squared. We know that when you plug in 0, this is 0. When you plug in negative 1, this is 1. When you plug in negative 2, this is 4. When you plug in 1, is 1. When you plug in 2, is 4. Now compare this. The factor here, 20, if you divide this one, divide. Okay, now this one here, you cannot divide by 0. 0 is a 0. But anyway, for here, what do you get? this is 5. This is 5. This is 5. This is 5. So you can see that that's the increment of 5. And what conclusion we have from here is a f at x stretch the graph by a factor of a vertically. So vertically, so we did this way, we stretch this way. So what if f at x, when f at x equal to x squared, when it's negative 1, it is 1. So basically it will be here. When it's 2, it will be 4. So negative 2, it will be 4, it will be here. Same thing here on this side. So 0 will be still 0. So the graph here will look like this. For f at x equals to x squared, you can see apparently this graph is stretched vertically by 5 units, as shown here. So by the factor a, which is this one here. So that's how it's being shown. Let's do one more. We will do y equals to f at k at x is supposed to compress the graph by a factor k horizontally. So let's see if it works that way. I'll erase everything here. Let's use f at x equals to 3x squared for that example. Or that you can see it as 9x squared. So anyway, we can start finding the plots, the points, then we can actually do this. So now, I will use 0, negative 1, negative 2 as infinity. So 1 and 2. You plug 0 here, 0 times 3 is 0, 0 squared is 0. Negative 1 times 3, negative 3 squared is 9. Negative 2 times 3, negative 6 squared is 36. Same here, 1 times 3 is 3, 3 squared is 9. 2 times 3 is 6, 6 squared is 36. Now I will plot this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. 7, 8, 9, 10. I would do, because this is big, so I would do increment of 5 again. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. That's good enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. How about this? Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5, negative 6. So I will start plotting this using a different color. When is 0? X is 0, Y is 0. So here, when X is negative 1, Y is 9. So it will be somewhere here, right below 10. X is negative 2, will be 36, somewhere here, right above 35. Same thing here, when X is 1, Y is 9, somewhere here. When X is 2, Y is 36, so somewhere here. Get it better spot, get in a better spot. So 2 here. Okay, I have good enough points to draw the rough sketch of this graph, so I'll try my best. Here. So this sign now. Okay, last one here. Okay, so that's a rough sketch of this parabola. But anyway, let's compare the y value with the corresponding x value in the original graph that we make for y equals to for f at x equals to x squared, so this value here, to compare to the transformation here. So I'll use different color here. So let's say f at x equals to x squared, that's what we are trying to look at. If we plug in the x, same x value 0 to this, you will have 0. We plug in negative 1, so it's 1. When I plug in negative 2, it's 4. Same here, 1 square 1, 4 square, 2 square 4. So divide this value. You get 9 here, you get 9 here. Same here, you get 9 here, you get 9 here. So it's the same incremental factor here. This is 9. Basically here, 9. So let's drop plug the graph here. So 0, 0, same here, not changing. When it's negative 1, is 1. So 1 will be somewhere here. Same on this side. When it's negative 2, would be 9, so somewhere here. No, when it's negative 2, is 4. So it would be here, right below 5. Same on this side, right below 5. Now I can just sketch the graph roughly. It will look like this. This is f at x equals to x squared. And the one in red is actually f at x equals to 3x all squared, basically 9x squared. You can see it is true that it seems like it's compressed horizontally. So let's look at it as like this here, like from this way. So over here, this is the same as kx squared, and that is the same as k squared x squared. We know that when x is negative 1, let's take positive, when x is positive 1, for f at x equal to 3x squared, you get a value 9. But for f at x equal to x squared, you get a value 1. And the incremental change is really 9. But over here, this is the same as 3 square x squared. So it is, or we can also say that it is compressed horizontally by the factor 3. But in fact, it's 3 squared. So hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you.